We offer a full line of high-quality Amana Tool bits that virtually fit any need that you have on the CNC. Not only do we do that, we also offer the Vectric files for you to download from our website with all of that tooling information so that you don't have to input it into the CNC yourself. So when you buy a bit, you can go and download the Vectric master file and you can see there all of the different tools that we offer. I'm going to take you through right now and show you how you can do that yourself. We do also offer it for Fusion 360 as well, but this video will just cover the Vectric side of things. There's going to be a couple different ways that we can get to the Vectric files. Number one, we go to our website, toolstoday.com, and you can just scroll all the way to the bottom, go to company, and then there's the Vectric and Fusion 360 tool files. We'll click that, and that'll bring up this page here. Here we have different sets that are listed here, and then this is the master tool file. So we'll click that, and that will download the file. I already have it saved here, so we'll download that to our computer. We'll click save, and you will not try to open this file through here. You're going to need to open your Vectric software. This will work for VCarve, VCarve Pro, or Spire, really any of the Vectric softwares. You'll open a new window, come over to your Tool Paths tab, and then click on the Tool Library. If you love this type of content, be sure to subscribe to our channel and go ahead and hit that bell so that you'll be notified on all of the new videos when they're released. Also, don't forget to follow us on Instagram at ToolsToday. So this will display the tool database. This is what I currently have in there, but we're going to add a new one. So you're going to want to come down to the Import Tool Database button. There's the one that we just downloaded. Click Open, and that will import all of those tools. Now you can see that we have a new tool database here that has all of the different tools in it. So these are all categorized by the type of bit that they are. Within each section, there is a category for the type of bit and then the material that it is. So it makes it a little bit easier to find everything. And then within each one of those categories, we have it set up for the shank size so that you can get it narrowed down pretty quickly. Unfortunately, there's not a search feature on Vectric, so you are going to need to go through and find the bits. What I would suggest here is the bits that you use the most, I would create another folder outside of this. So just come down here, create a new group. We'll click that, and then the bits that you use the most, you can just drag up into that new group. That way you don't have to search for everything every time. Also, if you have a machine that does not take these size shanks, you can definitely delete those off of there just by coming through here and hitting the delete button, and that will remove all of those tools. So that way you don't have to look through stuff that you're not using, and that will work pretty well for you. So there's different ways, like I said, by the style a bit. We have V-bits on here, depending on the type of material, and then the shank size as well. Same thing with the engraving bits, flattening bits, really anything like that on the Vectric software. It's all broken down to make things a little bit easier for you to be able to find. So all of the tool information is there. Vectric does not take into account the cut height of the actual bits. So a lot of these bits are going to be very, very similar. If you have a bit, it is basically the same as another. It just has a larger cut height that's not listed in here. You can go ahead and create a new one just simply by hitting the copy button. That will create a new version of the same one. We can import the settings over from the previous one, and then you can create something with a new cut height, or if you want to change the feeds and speeds, all that kind of stuff. You can see that each bit has all of the feeds and speeds information for you, ready to go. These are set for Amana tools. They're only meant to be used with Amana tools. Each bit manufacturer is going to have different specifications, and these are specifically meant for the Amana tool brand. So they will work perfectly with that. So that's one way to get to the Vectric files. The other way is if, let's say, you're looking for a bit. So let's go to this one here. There's going to be a link right underneath it that is the link to go to the tool files where you can download those. We do also have some of those available for Fusion 360 as well. So you can definitely get those there. But let's say that you want to adjust the feed rates. You can click right here, and this will show you a speeds and feeds chart with all of the recommended feeds and speeds for those bits. The feeds and speeds on the Vectric software are a starting point. They aren't too aggressive, and they can be increased for some bits using the formulas that we have here on our feeds and speeds charts right down here. So if you want to increase those, that will tell you what you need to increase the RPM to versus what you increase the feed rate. So anyways, hopefully that helps answer some questions there. And if there is a tool that you are finding on the website that is not there or not in the Vectric file, definitely feel free to send us a message and we will do our best to get those added there and get something created for you. Having this tool file available takes away a lot of the time-consuming aspects of adding bits, especially when you get into bits like these that have much more specific diameters that need to be absolutely accurate, and takes away a lot of the potential issues that you might run into when trying to import them yourself. It'll definitely decrease the time that you're spending setting up your tools and more time spending actually cutting things. So anyways, hopefully this helps. And if you have any questions, certainly feel free to ask and we will do our best to answer any of those. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you love this type of content, be sure to subscribe right over here. And for more great videos, click right over here.